Welcome back to CAD/CAM tutorial. In the last lecture of SOLIDWORKS simulation, we did this body and we create a simulation for this body, and here we applied 1000 Newton force and we calculated stress, strain, displacement in this body. Now here we found, now we forget to create the factor of safety and report, personal report. So today we will make create factor of safety and personal report. So just right click here. Now for factor of safety, if you want to see how much pressure on any node or any point, you can directly select here stress and choose probe, and you can select any point. See, now here node shows what is the node. Node actually, it is a when we convert our body into multiple number of meshes, each meshes has 3 points, so that is called node. And this is the location of the node and value of the node in terms of pressure, Newton per square meter. See, so this is simple, you can calculate the force at any point. Okay, now if you want to see, right click mesh and here select detail. Now here in the mesh you can select what kind of mesh we selected for this body. This is the standard mesh, and at here you can we selected the size 2.64. this is the actual size of our node, and how many total number of nodes and total number of elements. Nodes always 3 nodes in one element, so this is multiplied by 3. So this is the value you can calculate for the mesh. Sometime it is required. Now let's check how to check the factor of safety for this product. So simply select here result advisor, select new plot and choose here factor of safety. Now once you select factor of safety, select here next, next, okay. Now see, this red zone shows it is the maximum factor of safety. You cannot go beyond this point. So at the bottom you will see 6.65:100. This is the maximum factor of safety, and the minimum is this is minimum factor of safety, and the maximum is 3.640. The blue area is always safe zone and the red area always in danger zone. So beyond this you will not go. If you go beyond this, your part will be distort or destruct. So this is how we calculate the factor of safety. See, factor of safety distribution 6.7. now you can even perform many things here. Even let's say, now let me select show. If you go to plot section clipping, now see this arrow. If you want to see at which point how much the safety factor of safety and how much distortion and displacement happened, this blue area always is safe zone. See, if you drag and you will find this intersection view, and you will see, and you can directly use the node command and check how much factor of safety there. So there are multiple ways. This is one way. The another one way is cylindrical. You just draw a cylinder and you will see the body will pass through this cylinder, and you will see the last one is a sphere. So let's just pass this sphere. Actually this is moving along with one axis. This is, I think, front axis. Even you can choose the axis, it's up to you. You can select right plane. Now see, at the sphere whatever portion come, it will show you the area. Okay, so this is the one of the way you can calculate the stress, displacement, strain in the body, and we can calculate the factor of safety with the help of these kinds of command. Now even you will see one more tool here, ISO clip. If you want to see layer wise, now look, if you will increase ISO value, see, if you will increase or decrease, you will see exactly inside. If you will see inside, the blue area is always safe zone, the displacement and destructions less happen in that area. If you'll see, so this is also one of the way if you want to check inside the body. So ISO way we can use, ISO clipping way. Okay, now this is the simple way what we calculate the factor of safety. Plot factor of safety. Next, finish. Now this area is safe, this material now in safe zone. Now let's create the personal report. How to create a personal report? If you perform any kind of simulation, the whole thing will be saved in your system and you can directly perform a creative report in Word file. Now let's create the personal report for this product or for this part. So you can directly select your report. Once you select report, it will ask you multiple number of data and it will create you a perfect professional report. Here see, it is checked all the part and see, if you want to exempt. Now here see, whatever data do you like to show in your report, you can check all these things. If you don't like anything, you just unchecked. Now here you will see, you will put your informations. So let's start with CAD CAM tutorial. Here you have to put designer name. Here you have to select your company name, Electro Industry. Electro Industries. Now you have to put your URL. So www.electroi.com. Then you have to select your logo here. So select here and in the desktop I put my logo. Select here all files. Okay, CAD CAM tutorial logo open. Now here you have to select, so Jeddah, Saudi Arab. Now you have to put your phone number, whatever your phone number, A, B, C, D. That's, if you like to put your fax number, you can directly select your any kind of fax number. Now here it is asking you report path, where do you like to save your report. So I'll choose here and let me select desktop. Okay, now it will ask you report on publish. Select here apply, and once you select apply, choose publish. Once you select public, it will save and it will going to open. So first it will calculate, it will calculate from start to end, it will calculate each and everything and it will give you a professional report at the each point. See, it's going to see the how much pressure applied, how much strain development, stress and displacement happened in the body. It will calculate each and everything and it will give you a profession in a professional way. It will calculate how much nodes we applied, mesh we applied, number of nodes, number of mesh. It will calculate each and everything. It will calculate the deformation point, maximum minimum point. So it's near to finish. Once it will finish, it will automatically open in, I think, documents file, Word documents. Now see, it's going to open in Word file. Now look, let me okay, now see, first you will see your logo. then your company name, your address, phone number, URL, and this is simulation of part F. This is our part, and you will see date, designation, name, and everything. Now here you will see table of content. If you want any data description, you can directly click and edit and write anything. See, you will see a complete list of your simulation procedures. Then header and footer, everything will be automatically added at each page. Now this is the solid body and volumetric property, mass, volume, density, weight, how much here you will see. Then study report, the name, how many mesh is there, this all will be here. Then units, what kind of unit we used here. Now this is the property of material, alloy, steel, and what are the yield strength, tensile strength, everything will be calculated and you will get a complete information here. This is the fixed part. This force is applied on this hole, so this detail also you will get here. This is mesh information, how many number of mesh, solid mesh, and how many size of the mesh quality high, number of nodes, how many number of elements, all the things you will get here. Now see, this is the mesh body. See, there are multiple small multiple number of meshes, and here you will find the sum of units, forces applied, and result. See, 1000 newton force we applied, and this is the study result. This is the main result, maximum and minimum value for your product. See, if it will go beyond this, maybe your product will distort or damaged. Now this is the displacement report, maximum and minimum value, and this is the stress strain report, and this is the your factor of safety, how much your factor of safety minimum and maximum. Your condition, this is your main condition, what we calculate factor of safety. So this is the simple report how we created by SolidWorks simulation software. I hope you like it. Don't forget to share and like our video. If you have any comments, just write down below. We will try to answer each and every question. Please share this video and subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks and other softwares like Inventor. Thanks for watching.